Before my video today, I wanted to get a shout out to the Unbox Therapy channel. They do giveaways and unbox all the latest tech toys. Here's a clip.
Lou here, back with another unboxing video, and today we're taking a look at a very interesting item.
Included this annotation here so you can go check them out and subscribe. And if you're on a mobile device, click the link in the description box below. And don't forget to tell them that I sent you. This would be a great channel to go subscribe to, especially on this video I'm going to be talking to you about today. It's going to be about the Apple event that was last week. And Lou from Unbox Therapy is going to be covering all of that. I am not a sole tech channel. I'm just giving my opinion. So it's definitely worth your while to go check him out if you aren't subscribed to him already. Hey people! So as you know, Apple had a conference a few days ago, and there was both excitement and disappointment in the audience. Now, me personally, I had a whole bunch of feels. So first, let's talk about Mavericks. I am over the flipping moon with Mavericks. Like, if you could marry both an operating system and a human, I would probably do that. For most people, they were just like, meh, this is a small little upgrade. But for monitor whores like myself and people that like to multitask, this is long overdue. You can have an application in full screen on one monitor and still work on the other one. The dock pops up on every single monitor as long as you hover your mouse down towards the bottom, and it just kind of appears from the bottom up. And the top menu bar is on every bloody monitor. The one you're working on goes solid, and the other two are kind of like a ghost version of it. Seriously, guys. Seriously. Nerdgasm. Or YouTuber slash graphic designer gasm. You pick. And if any of you out there are questioning whether or not to get a second monitor, if it's gonna really increase your productivity, trust me, it will at least double it, if not more. It increases your workflow immensely. There are a ton of other little cool features like tabs and Finder, color codes for folders, which is great for if you're writing an essay or doing a report of some kind, or just to organize your Mac in general. And AirPlay is pretty cool as well. And as if Apple couldn't make my day any better, they made the freaking update completely free. How much was it, Windows users? That's right, free! Along with all of iWork and iLife when you purchase a new Mac. Sorry, I just have a few friends that argue with me about Windows versus Mac OS X, but their upgrades usually make them compromise in some really nice hardware, because they have to put the $200 out to get Windows. And as a Hackintosh user, that kind of makes me giggle a wee bit. And don't get me wrong, I don't discriminate. If you use Windows and it works for you and it gets the job done, that is so fantastic, you don't know, because any technology that benefits someone's life is good technology, in my opinion. But still, no one on this planet can argue that Windows Movie Maker is better than iMovie. You just can't. It's just, it's light years better. Light years. So as you can see, this part of the keynote had me jumping out of my bloody socks. However, the Max announced in this keynote is what made my big smile kind of dip down to a half frowny slash emotionless face. Like this. The first Macs announced were the new MacBook Pros. And honestly, I think that Apple made a pretty big mistake here. I currently have a 2012 base 15-inch MacBook Pro Retina, and I love that machine. It's just my child. And it came with dedicated graphics. I also got that computer for a flat $2,000. That's right. I have people. So for me, this laptop was a steal, especially since the new baseline 15-inch MacBook Pro Retina does not have dedicated graphics. To get dedicated graphics in the 15-inch model, you have to shell out an additional $600. Now, though I think this is a bit ridiculous, Apple did lower the price of the baseline 15-inch MacBook Pro Retina so that more people could afford it, but they bummed down the actual internals so that it could be put down at that price point. Now, I don't see why they couldn't have put dedicated graphics in there, the same card that I have now, because it's a good card. It is a smaller graphics card than what is in the advanced version of the MacBook Pro Retina, and I don't think that that would have cost them much more to do that. So even if they kept it at the existing price point, I think people would have been a lot happier with that. And if you have the $600 to get the most advanced version of that computer, I would definitely do it because the graphics card in that system is pretty boss. But nonetheless, if you do have a 15-inch MacBook Pro Retina that you got 2012 or this year, do not sell that computer. It is a very good computer, and I would say arguably It is just below the new one that was just released, baseline, because the speeds are going to be a little bit higher in the new one, but it is still a really good computer, and I don't think you have a reason to upgrade. And Apple also dropped or cut out the standard models completely, except for the 13-inch model, which I just noticed yesterday. I also think that Apple made a big boo-boo here. Not everybody wants a Retina display, and not to really part with an optical drive, but I guess they did give you an option by getting the 13-inch MacBook Pro. And me personally, I knew this shift was inevitable, but I think that they're jumping the gun too quickly and they should have kept that 15 model available. They still have a market and I think they would still make money from it. The next Mac they talked about was the long-awaited Mac Pro. Now, I am not gonna lie, this machine looks amazeballs. The specs are quite impressive. However, it has a price tag to match, starting at a whopping $3,000. This machine is out of reach for most of the population, but that was kind of Apple's intention. Apple has a great line of computers right now, including the iMac. The Mac Pro is meant for professional users. Not saying that a professional can't use a MacBook Pro Retina or they can't use an iMac or even a Mac Mini. The Mac Pro is a machine meant for hardcore professionals, professionals that want to render 4K video using a Mac. And as you guys know, I go to an art college and we do have an amazing animation program there. And all of the students use PCs there because they can configure a PC that's under $3,000 that can render video that is that large. So now Apple has kind of stepped up their game and created a system that can handle that type of thing. Hell, they even support 3 4K displays or 6 Thunderbolt displays. That is holy crap. Like, I have a Hackintosh. There's no way I would even try with my Hackintosh. I would be scared that my graphics card would just go boop, 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 boop. So that is bloody incredible. And with that type of power, you have to expect a hefty price tag. Even if you're building a computer yourself, you're gonna be paying around the $3,000 mark. Granted, it may be faster than a quad core. You may be able to get a 6-core or something like that for way less money than what you would be paying for the Mac Pro. But for people that are in the arts industry, most of them prefer using a Mac and they will pay this price to get that power. So I'm not really upset by the price, to be honest with you. Me personally, I would get an iMac if I were to buy an actual desktop. You can upgrade the iMac to be a beast of a machine, and I wouldn't need to put extra money to get a Mac Pro. I would be more than happy with an iMac. Plus, you get the beautiful display. And lastly, Apple discussed the iPad, and this is where most of the people are complaining, I guess you could say. Not because of the iPad Mini now having a Retina display, everybody liked that, but they are also disappointed with the $399 price tag. I personally knew this was gonna happen because Retina displays are not cheap, and I knew Apple had to up the price somewhat, and I'm actually surprised they only upped it to $399. And then we got the new iPad Air, which looks really, really pretty. It's really light. It would be an iPad I would pick up personally. That's the only complaint I have, is if I had a choice between a $399 iPad Mini and a $499 iPad Air, I'd probably shell out the extra $100 for the iPad Air for the bigger screen. But nonetheless, I am happy to see a Retina display in the Mini. I think that's awesome. And I'm also happy that they kept the iPad Mini on board and just lowered the price down to $299 to give consumers an option for a cheaper iPad still. Now, the thing that everybody was like, what the deuce, was the iPad 2 being put back in the lineup. And I completely agree with this, but standing back from a business point of view, I understand why they put it there. They put it there because they wanted an iPad with lesser graphics, lesser speed, with a lesser screen below the iPad Air, whereas the Mini is there and it has the standard screen. So they wanted to make it an equal platform. They released 4 MacBook Pros and now they've released 4 iPads. What I think they should have done is they should have cut out that iPad completely and not had one under the iPad Air. I don't think they needed it. It is fine with just the 3. Because if you put the iPad 4 in there, yes, it has the lightning cable, but it is a fairly new iPad in my opinion. It is a good iPad. It has a Retina display. You could not price that at $399, it would have to be higher. So yes, I think they should have cut that iPad out completely and stuck with the 3 iPads. I think that that would have been strong enough, and they would have had an iPad Mini at $299, an iPad Mini with Retina display for $399, and then the iPad Air starting at $499, and I think that overall works really nicely. If you agree with me, let me know down below. Me personally, the only reason I did not get the iPad 4th generation is because it is incredibly heavy, and I like to read in bed, I like to watch videos in bed, and I just don't want to drop that boat anchor on my face. So that's why I got the iPad Mini, which is on my tripod right now, and I'm using it for notes. And I love this little thing. Honestly, it's great. I have no reason to really upgrade to the Retina display, but I'm glad it is available if ever I do want to upgrade at some point. Now, going back to the title of this video, is Apple losing its edge? Personally, I think the answer to this question is no. And this isn't just because I am an Apple fangirl. Trust me, it's not like that. I'm looking at it from a consumer's point of view. Apple is taking huge leaps forward. And guys, you need to understand they are at the top. They have adapted an iOS that has been pretty much the same all the way up until iOS 7. They took a huge leap forward by changing the design, and I think they did that very, very well. It is beautiful. I love the design layout. I would have changed a couple colors, but that is very minor in my opinion. And it runs overall, it runs very smoothly. I love the changes. It really has given iOS a breath of fresh air. That's my personal opinion. If you think otherwise, that is totally fine too. They've also broadened up their devices, guys. They only had one iPad. They only had one iPhone. They now have the iPhone 5C and the 5S. They have two different iPhones that you can choose from. They have two different types of iPads now. iPad mini, iPad Air as of now. And they've added a Retina display to a mini. Like, they are going full speed ahead and they are giving us products that we want. So for me personally, is Apple losing their edge? I still think no, but I can understand why people might think that they are. Things aren't the way they were when Steve Jobs was here. Granted, if Steve Jobs was here, is this the way that Apple would be changing? We really don't know. He probably had influence on what is coming out now. But one thing you need to understand, guys, is Apple is probably one of the biggest companies in the world. When they release a new product, the amount of hype around that product is crazy. And if you're an Android user or a Windows Phone user, that is fantastic. Good on you. I'm glad that you like what you use if you do like it. But you cannot deny that the hype around Apple products is far superior than any other device. They sell out within like an hour of opening up a store, not even kidding. And the amount of phones that they need to actually have on start date is crazy in comparison to any other type of phone. Same with the iPad, any other type of tablet. So they have very big shoes to fill, and it's probably incredibly stressful. So taking a risk within this company is a lot bigger than taking a risk if you're Android or taking a risk if you're Windows Phone, because not as many people are gonna care about it. So me personally, I think that they're doing a great job. I am a little weirded out by the iPad 2. Like, why? I understand why, but at the same time, from a consumer point of view, I'm like, the deuce. And with the MacBook Pros, they are premium systems anyway. I don't think they really needed to worry about lowering the price as much as they were, and they should have kept dedicated graphics in the baseline, because those computers are incredibly expensive and you should expect to have a premium card in that system. Granted, the ones that are actually in there are supposed to be pretty decent, but I still would like to see dedicated graphics in the base model 15-inch model. And with the 13-inch model, there is no quad core. Why, Apple? Give the option to have quad core. Quad core is like standard now, in my personal opinion. But anyways, guys, those are my thoughts. What did you think about the whole keynote down below? What do you think about the new products released? What are you picking up? Are you buying any of them? Are you sticking with what you already have? I'd love to read it down below. If you like this video, don't forget to smack that like button. Comment down below. Follow and share this video any way you can. Twitter, Bookfaces, Instagram, Google Pluses. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel for new videos. And until next time, people, toodles. Hey people, this video is going to be a lot different from what I normally do. And it is because I've come across something that has helped my family and many others in a huge way.